Oskaloosa residents might soon have to pay a higher fee after consuming gas and electricity. Each month, properties classified as commercial, residential, public entity, and industry have to pay a franchise fee on their MidAmerican Energy bill. The City Council is considering increasing that fee by 2% across the board for all sectors that get a bill. That's because of recent property tax legislation that will make the city lose money. Add the request for funding from the YMCA, the animal shelter, and the forest cemetery into the mix, and well, the city is trying to find a way to keep everything running smoothly. CRI explains.
The Iowa legislature recently passed a property tax reform. City manager Michael Schrock says the reform is aimed at making Iowa more competitive when it comes to business retention. But a part of that reform will cause a dent in the city's budget.
Right now, there are properties that are maybe an apartment complex. They're charged through property taxes at 100% of their assessed value. And through the reform bill that was passed, eventually over a number of years, that assessed that the property won't be taxed at the same 100% value.
Over the next 10 years, multifamily apartment complexes will see a 50% cut in their property taxes. And that change alone means the city will receive $500,000 less each year on property tax revenue starting on fiscal year 2017 up until 2024. And Schrock says that's a conservative estimate.
Beginning fiscal year 17 and beyond, it's going to be a pretty significant impact to the city of Oskaloosa. We're talking hundreds of thousands of dollars a year in lost property tax revenue.
The city is trying to find a way to maintain its services intact without having to back out on financial requests from the Forest Cemetery, the Animal Shelter, and the YMCA. The Y requested $200,000 each year for the next 3 years. The YMCA already had financial struggles, and now its pool has broken down, causing a bigger leak in the Y's finances. The YMCA is estimating a deficit this year of roughly $50,000.
Of course, you've been hearing there's a lot of repairs needed into the building. The community uses the YMCA. We need it, YMCA.
But with less funds available due to the loss of property tax revenue, the city council is considering a franchise fee increase that'll help towards the Y's request.
My view is that if you let the public know what it's going to be used for and you use it for that, I don't think there'll be too much of an issue there. Of course, you're going to have some folks, you know, some of the public will, you know, not agree with it.
Currently, properties classified as commercial, residential, and public entities pay a 3% franchise fee, and properties classified as industry pay a 1.5% franchise fee. The council is looking at increasing the franchise fee 2% across the board, and that would tentatively start in November. For example, if a resident consumes $50 of gas and electricity each month, instead of paying an additional $1.50 of franchise fees, the resident would now pay $2.50 of franchise fees.
It's no secret a franchise fee, user fees, is a tax.
The money from the franchise fee at a 3% rate generates roughly $400,000 a year for the city. By increasing the franchise fee by 2%, the city will generate an extra $290,000 per year going forward. Remember, starting in 2017, the city loses $500,000 a year in revenue. But by the time 2017 rolls around, the franchise fee increase will have already generated almost $900,000. So that would help the city delay the blow going forward. Schrock says it's important for the council to consider funding the YMCA because of its child care services. About 400 children are currently enrolled in the Y's child care service.
And I think if that goes away in the immediate future, I think the far-reaching complications or the impacts of that on this community will be felt for years and years. And I think it becomes very difficult to attract families employees with families to come to Oskaloosa if they don't have a dependable and reliable daycare. So that's just one piece of it.
The council is planning on funding the Y's request for $200,000 with the hope of finding a long-term solution for the upcoming years.
If they do that, there needs to be a plan put in place to assess what the needs are of the community for recreation, for child care, the whole thing. Come up with that plan, develop a way of funding it, and then presenting that to all of the entities that are responsible or have a vested interest in it.
But that's not the only major request the city has to consider. Schrock says the city will continue to contribute $100,000 in funding for the Forest Cemetery annually. but the $150,000 request over 3 years to build a new animal shelter might have to be spread out over more than 3 years. The city can commit $25,000 annually for the shelter going forward. In the meantime, the city is planning on putting a halt on demolition and acquisition projects and on hiring a new part-time code enforcement officer. Truck says the city will evaluate all possible ways to trim the budget to prepare for the loss of property tax revenue.
Schrock says it's not uncommon for a community of Oskaloosa size to fund a YMCA. Schrock says the city of Indianola, Simpson College, and Indianola's Y recently partnered to construct a recreational facility. Schrock says it's important to look at all partnership options going forward. The city council has yet to vote on increasing the franchise fee. It will discuss the item in the next city council meeting on August 4th. If the council approves the franchise fee increase, it would tentatively take effect in November.